गुड मॉर्निंग बे, आप सभी लोग हमारे तरफ से एक प्यार भरा नमस्ते,
नमस्कार,
वनकम,
नमस्कार,
खुशामदीन,
सलाम अलैकुम,
सत श्री अकाल,
मी कांदरे की वंदर में,
जय स्वामी नारायण,
जय श्री कृष्णा,
जय जनेंद्रा,
हमारे इस्माइली भाई बंधु को बोल दे याली मदद,
मोलाली मदद बोलते हैं सारे फीजी मंदिर को बोलेंगे नीसा बुला बनजान, हम आ गए हैं आपके प्यारे महिमा के द्वारा, मैं से फालतू बाबा
And of course, myself, Faltu Rani, lekar aapke liye ek aur drive time that's going to make it totally exciting and totally, totally mastani ban jayega.
Shuru da ban jaye, abhi ke liye aapke liye, without any further ado, I bring to you the traffic update right now on the Bay Area roads ban jayega.
It's time for the Bandhu traffic update. Call us from wherever you are at 408-912-2479.
That is a standard request for everybody out there, stuck in traffic or not stuck in traffic. If you actually experience some kind of traffic congestion, whatever it is, you might not know there's an accident now, but if at all your traffic is slowing down where you're going right now, wondering, oh my God, what's happening there? Pick up the phone, let us know, Brinjan, so we can actually update CHP as well. And speaking about traffic on the roads, it's still, the volume is low, it's still the, looks like the COVID situation itself, but 880 as usual has some kind of congestion going on, but no incidents report over there. It is near the San Leonzo area, Brinjan, and in Hayward side, so watch out, if at all you're going to go outside, probably you'll have some delays. The highway advisory on 80 eastbound and westbound, and Livermore side again, 580 is advising high winds on the Vasco Road in Livermore. So watch out, drive very carefully in those regions, Brinjan. I don't see any incidents whatsoever, even for the past 15 minutes, 20 minutes, I don't see any incidents on the roads, at least reported right now on the space CH, Brinjan. So if at all there's something which you want to share with our bandhus, give us a call, 408-912-2479. And that was a road traffic update, Brinjan. Weather-wise, dekhna chahiye to, of course, it's going to be sunny all day today. It's going to be in the mid-60s, not going to be too hot. That's one thing good, actually, because, in fact, the whole weekend is going to be kind of in the 70s or mid-70s. It would maximum go that way on Saturday. Sunday, we might have some really hot weather.
Mm-hmm.
We're expecting something in the upper 80s.
What?
Yeah. But it's going to be good all the way. It's going to be a little bit of, there's no clouds at all, no rain at any point. There's no supposed to be no rains at all. But it might seem kind of cloudy today, but they'll definitely burn out, Brinjan, because the whole day is going to be bright and sunny for you guys. And that was your weather update and traffic update. A quick look at what's happening with the news headlines for you guys coming right up. And you can actually catch the headlines with our at our news blog, mediamahima.com. Lekin Fadhwani, aaj ka, that is April 13th ka news kya hai?
From the Radio Dihari studios in the Silicon Valley, Panajan, these are your news headlines from across the United States and the local Bay Area live. The United States calls for pause on Johnson & Johnson's COVID-19 vaccine over rare blood clots. How worried should we be about the blood clots? We'll talk a little bit more about it in detail during the news in detail. Derek Chauvin's lawyer call officer in the previous arrest to the stand as the first witness. Black man killed by police in Minnesota was an amazing and a loving kid, witnesses describe. And in local Bay Area news, Panjan, Santa Clara County scrambles ahead of the surge of COVID-19 vaccine eligibility. And returning Salesforce employees will have to be fully vaccinated, according to news sources. So more on all of this coming up shortly.
That's right, Brinjan. All the information coming right up in just a few minutes. But of course, pehle, a quick look at our Gaadega Kida lined up for you guys, Brinjan. A nice song from a movie, once again. Did not do much the box office. I haven't seen it because this movie, I think, turned out to be an OTT release before even OTT was famous. Yeah, Saif Ali Khan's movies were probably ignored at the box office for some reason. But anyway, Brinjan, right now, this is a song I'll end up for you guys in the voice of course, Raghu Dixit. If you're wondering who Raghu Dixit, Brinjan, he's the rock star with the lungi. Yeah. Karan Banjan, and a nice song which is actually asking you to add some fun into your life, Banjan. Haan, bohat sara ho gaya. Ye iska ghisa pita, the COVID situation, economy situation, all those things, Banjan. Yes, eats up on us for sure. Lekin ye movie actually Raja Krishnamurthan ka mini film, Banjan. It's a very nice movie. Watch it. It's supposed to be a very heartwarming kind of movie. You've seen the movie, didn't you?
Yeah, I saw the movie.
Was it a bro? What is a bro?
It was okay. It got a little draggy towards. I just felt it was a little too slow paced.
But the story wise, I love it. That's one of my dreams actually.
It was a nice story. Yeah.
Yeah, my dream is to actually get a thing and start driving around the world.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Get a mobile kitchen and drive around the world.
Well, actually, mobile kitchen, yeah. But eventually, trailer is what I'm looking for, actually.
Trailer? What?
What do you call those things which actually are like, you know, those things where people take a bus? Like, no, the what do you call them? They call them vanity, right? No, what do they call them?
The mobile homes.
Mobile homes, yes, that's right. Mobile homes, actually, not a mobile home, actually. I want a trailer which I can drive, literally.
I know.
On different parts of it and go, you know, check out all parts of the world, right? Go all over the world, actually.
A mobile home is a trailer, sorta.
Sorta.
I think, because...
Oh, my God, sorta. You know, in this particular movie, there's one particular scene which I totally love.
Uh-huh.
On the parboiled rice, they put a little bit of fish curry.
That's Kerala, right? Mm,
and they have, mirchi, hari mirch, and they have potatoes fry.
Oh, God, I'll to stop. Mm. First
and
thing
fish
in the morning.
Fry.
Yuck.
Mm-hmm. What? Hello? Excuse me, what? First thing in the morning? First thing in the morning, you got to eat.
No,
that's called breaking the fast.
Yeah, not if you're intermittent fasting.
That is your problem, not my problem, Falzwani. And of course, Bajan, that was, I'm talking about the movie which at the chef, jo film hai, jahan pe ek chef jo hai, who supposedly works abroad, right? And goes to India, go back to India? Was
yeah.
That, okay. And then he goes back to India and tries to live his dream or whatever, find something, soul, whatever soul searching thing which he does. And that's a very nice, that's a good movie. It was a takeoff on an English movie.
Yeah, yeah. It's a book, right? Or a movie, English
Wasn't
movie.
Wasn't an English movie called Chef itself?
Yeah, something like that.
Ah, there you go. I was wondering, like, you know, I've seen this kind of a sequence somewhere and also. But anyway, Bajan, that was your movie, Karinga Kira, for you guys. The Ghana was awesome, wasn't it? Right? It sends a lot of message to you guys. Sugar laga lo. Thoda bahut sugar laga ho life, Bajan. Lekin abhi aapke liye sugar ke badle mein hum log juice lagayenge. Falzwani, what is the details, news for us? I really want to know what's happening with the JJ. So you're saying the people who have taken JJ showing symptoms?
Not everybody, But let me get you the detailed news on that. The U.S. Federal Health Agencies on Tuesday recommended pausing the use of Johnson & Johnson's COVID-19 vaccine after six women under 50 who were given the shot developed rare blood clots, dealing a fresh setback to efforts to tackle the pandemic. Following the news, Johnson & Johnson said that it was delaying the rollout of the vaccine to Europe a week after regulators there said they were reviewing rare blood clots in four recipients of the shot in the United States. The move comes after European regulators said earlier this month they had found a possible link between AstraZeneca's COVID-19 vaccine and a similar rare blood clotting problem that led to a small number of deaths as well.
And of course, please don't panic. If you've already taken JJ, don't panic. It's very rare. It's very rare condition. Now, here's the thing. They've actually listed out some symptoms you got to watch out for. If you find those symptoms, please go talk to your healthcare provider because they could probably, address it early. As opposed to wait, because if you're feeling more sore than anybody else, more than the 1 or 2 days, which generally happens for anybody, any vaccination, right? And then if you're having prolonged headaches or leg pain, specifically they're saying leg pain, please contact your healthcare provider and tell them that you actually had the JJ vaccine and that's what's happening to you. Now, it is a very rare condition. So don't think, oh my God, don't get panicky.
And it's largely in women between 18 and 48 years of
age. That's right. And largely in women. That's what they're also noticing. Well, again, it doesn't happen to men, but of course, please be mindful of symptoms. You got to take care of those things, and of course, any symptoms which are making you feel uneasy more than the stipulated time of 1 or 2 days, contact your healthcare provider and just let them know that you actually have the JJ vaccine. And supposedly they're able to fix it. It's actually a clot happening near the bottom portion of the brain, near the neck, that kind of thing. So you got to make sure you're asking people also in your family who sometimes in our culture, you know, right, Falzwani, women don't say they have pains.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they don't report it. So you got to be mindful and ask them about what's happening, if at all you're taking a JJ vaccine, Manujan.
Right. And also, Manujan, what exactly has happened here with both AstraZeneca and Johnson & Johnson? Basically, these vaccines are a different type of vaccine, right, from Pfizer and Moderna.
Mm-hmm.
Because the platform on which these were built were more of that virus vector that is injected into you, right? So they're suspecting that this could be... common between the two, that's possibly causing, there could be a causal link is what they're suspecting, but it's not proven yet. The reports actually from both these vaccines involve extremely rare clotting, including a type of blood clot called the cerebral venous sinus thrombosis.
That's the one right below your brain.
Yeah, that was seen in combination with low levels of blood platelets called thrombocytopenia.
Wow.
The U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention Committee plans to review the cases linked to the J&J vaccine, and the U.S. Food and Drug Administration will review its analysis as well. So if... as far as I know, in Contra Costa County, at least one of the Bay Area counties has stopped issuing the J&J vaccine. Remember, this is just an advisory or a recommendation from CDC so far. So many Santa Clara County, as well as other counties, do have the J&J vaccine. But it's only Contra Costa County which has come forward and said that they will not be administering the J&J vaccine to people who come to their clinics.
Yeah, but of course, I heard news that Alameda County actually has opened up for everybody above 16 who can take an appointment from MyTurn, right? Website.
Yes, that's what we shared yesterday. So again, if you are not sure about the J&J vaccine, and if you think that you have some form of any form of autoimmune condition, definitely it is not recommended, is what experts are saying. So definitely get in touch with your healthcare provider before you go and get a vaccine. Derek Chauvin's lawyers on Tuesday began presenting their case in the former Minneapolis policeman's murder trial, calling to the stand a now retired officer who pulled over a car in which Floyd was a passenger in 2019, a year before his deadly encounter with Chauvin. Chauvin's lead attorney, Eric Nelson, argued in court filings that the earlier arrest supported his defense that a drug overdose may have caused Floyd's death in May 2020, not a lack of oxygen caused by Chauvin kneeling on his neck for more than 9 minutes, said prosecutors, as the prosecutors had charged. Nelson showed the jury a video taken by a body-worn camera during the May 6, 2019 traffic stop, in which Floyd became distressed as the officer Scott Creighton pointed a gun at him and ordered him out of a car. The passenger was unresponsive and non-compliant to my commands, Creighton told the jury on Tuesday, describing Floyd as nervous and anxious. I then had to reach in for him because I wanted to see his hands. Before Creighton took the stand, Judge Peter Cahill warned jurors that the evidence was being submitted with the limited purpose of showing what effects the ingestion of opioids may have had on George Floyd. The evidence is not to be used as an evidence against the character of George Floyd, is what the judge said. But then again, you know, sometimes I wonder, how can people actually divorce that that thought process and the formation of perceptions while making their judgment call. It's really hard. I mean, and it's clear what they're trying to do is they're now trying to shame the victim, and they're saying that, oh, he was after all an opioid user. So it's, you know,
I wonder what would happen if at all he genuinely felt sorry for what he did. I don't know. They don't think of that as an option at all, is it?
No, they haven't. He hasn't apologized.
See, that's what I'm like, that shows like something, right? That there's something wrong there, right?
Yeah.
Hey, a life is gone. You shouldn't. It's like, you know, no matter what you talk, that's why I say, like, you know, anyway, let's see what happens. We're going to provide you all the information as the ruling comes up, Banujan, because we also watching very closely. Yeah.
Yeah. Chauvin, of course, is white, and he has pleaded not guilty to murder and manslaughter charges. a black man in the meanwhile, Banajan, Duante Wright, a 20-year-old black man who was fatally shot by a white police officer in Minneapolis suburb during a traffic stop on Sunday, was kind, liked baseball, and had a tight-knit family, according to media interviews with his relatives. Wright's mother, Katie Wright, told ABC News on Tuesday that her son was an amazing, loving kid who had a big heart, loved his sisters and brothers, and enjoyed playing basketball with his young son. He has a 2-year-old son that's not ever going to be able to play basketball with him again, his mother told ABC's Good Morning America. So, you know, this was another sad situation that came out of Minneapolis, Vinajan, the news that broke yesterday. But let's also, we'll bring you updates on that. Looks like there was a protest outside our SJPD as well with regard to this particular case that happened, where people are again, you know, rallying together with the Black Lives Matter movement.
Mm-hmm.
In the meanwhile, Vinajan, Santa Clara County Public Health Department is scrambling ahead of the expected surge of people trying to book appointments for their COVID-19 vaccine starting April 15th. Many residents have tried to book their appointment but encounter issues and confusion when trying to do so. They say that the website fails to recognize them as eligible for an appointment. However, Santa Clara County officials say that the website has been fixed and residents should no longer have issues with their eligibility.
Hmm.
And also news from San Francisco, Salesforce plans to bring people back to its massive San Francisco tower starting in May, and the employees who return will have to prove that they have been fully vaccinated against COVID-19. The announcement is raising some ethical and legal concerns. We can't really institute this until everybody's had a fair chance to get the vaccine. So until we can ensure that everyone's had an opportunity to access it, Dr. Charles Binkley, Director of Bioethics at Makula Center, said. Companies like Facebook, Intel, and Cisco have announced that returning employees will not have to be vaccinated, but all are strongly encouraging employees to do so. So you could get more information about that on MediaMahima.com. Those were the news in detail from across the Bay Area and also across the United States. Banjan, world news headlines and news in detail coming up shortly.
And of course, Banjan, all that coming up right now for you guys. But pehle aapko bol de ki, Banjan, this is actually the 390th day of our sheltering in place. This is why I'm telling you this, because I'm keeping track of this. Because people are expecting to go back to a normal life. It's not going to happen. I don't know. I've been reading up a lot about this thing for 20 years to what's going to happen after everything is vaccinated and everybody's vaccinated. We still are struggling with vaccinations. Not that I'm not giving you a sad picture about the whole thing. It's just that, you know, we are still in the process of getting fighting the virus. It is not completely out of our system.
Uh-huh.
We need to make sure that we actually create a new normal for ourselves. And this time, of course, we got to make sure we got to be more mindful about our family, about our surrounding, about our nature, everything together, put together, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's what you got to do. And we actually urge you guys to, to be make sure that you actually start leading a healthy life and start leading a life which is safe for everybody, right? Love for all is what I'm talking about, Fadwani. What do you think?
Right.
Love for all, Banajan. And right now, let me tell you, speaking of love for all, there's one particular thing which I really want all your love for is this particular event happening on 24th of April. This is actually an event which we love because it's totally put together by the Allies of Pragya. When I say Allies of Pragya, I'm talking about the Youth Allies of Pragya. Adults don't have anything to do with this whole event. It's just that them doing an event is outside their school. And you know how school closures have been really impactful on our children. And this is one way for them to connect socially and plan things. And they're doing this event for you guys. It's an outdoor event happening over here outside our studios. And we were excited to actually have them, you know, host them here in the studio, outside our studios. So definitely, if you want to take part in that event, go to pragya.org. It's called Step Up for Pragya. It actually is this particular month itself, right? They've declared this particular month itself as a month for awareness or acculturation, or should I say, a month for
neurodiversity
acculturation.
Yeah.
And that just means that, you know, learning about them and them learning about us. Like, you know, I'm talking about them. I should not be using the word them also. We are learning from each other is what I've got to be saying, because everybody is neurodiverse. We all are on some kind of a spectrum for sure. And this is one opportunity where you can come in and safely, because most of us already are vaccinated. If you're not vaccinated, probably you'll get it done by the time you get there for sure. Or just wear a mask, because everybody is mandated to wear masks in our event. We still maintain all the protocols protocols which Santa Clara County has given us almost 6 months ago, and we're still maintaining those protocols for physical distancing. We are making sure that we actually have masks for everybody and gloves required. And of course, if you have any PPEs, if you have falling short and you're having trouble buying those PPEs, equipment, we can actually supply to you guys. Give us a call or message us on facebook.com/RadioDHotties. We'd be happy to share the masks and the gloves and the sanitizers if you want for yourself. Let us know for sure. Pragnya is one of the people who can dispense it for you guys. So definitely message us on Radio D Hotties, Facebook page, facebook.com/RadioDHotties. But right now, Bajan, let's go check out what's happening with the news around the world. Fazwani, what do you think? Do you have something from around the world?
Yes, Aldebaba.
And here you go.
President Joe Biden has decided to withdraw U.S. troops from Afghanistan by September 11, 2021, 20 years to the day after al-Qaeda's attacks triggered America's longest war. Three sources familiar with the decision told Reuters. However, the withdrawal would be based on certain security and human rights guarantees, the sources said, speaking on condition of anonymity ahead of the formalization of the decision. The sources did not provide further details. Biden also proposes a summit with Putin amid tensions over Ukraine. U.S. President Joe Biden proposed this summit during a telephone call on Tuesday, in which he stressed the U.S. commitment to Ukraine's territorial integrity and voiced concern about a Russian military buildup in Crimea and on Ukraine's borders, the White House said. President Biden also made clear that the United States will act firmly in defense of its national interests in response to Russia's actions, such as cyber intrusions and election interference, the White House said in a brief statement. President Biden emphasized the United States' unwavering commitment to Ukraine's sovereignty and territorial integrity, and he voiced concerns over the buildup on the occupied Crimea and Ukraine borders. In the meanwhile, Russia has called the United States an adversary. Yes. Well, what happened exactly? Well, just a second, Madhujan. The United States called on Russia to halt a military buildup, as I mentioned before, in Moscow, in words recalling the Cold War. Moscow has said that its adversary should keep U.S. warships well away from annexed Crimea. Moscow seized Crimea from Ukraine in 2014, and fighting has escalated in recent weeks in eastern Ukraine, where government forces have battled Russian-backed separatists in a seven-year conflict that Kyiv says has killed 14,000 people. U.S. President Joe Biden, in a phone call with his Russian counterpart Vladimir Putin, emphasized Washington's unwavering commitment to Ukraine's sovereignty. But on the other hand, Putin is now calling United States a U.S. adversary and is rejecting a NATO call to end the Ukraine buildup. Opponents of the military rule in Myanmar cancelled traditional New Year festivities on Tuesday and instead showed their anger with the generals who seized power through low-key displays of defiance and small protests across the country. The United Nations Human Rights Office said it feared that the military clampdown on protests since the Feb 1 coup risked escalating into civil conflict like that seen in Syria, and appealed for a halt to the slaughter. In news from India, Banujan, India is to fast-track emergency approvals for the COVID-19 vaccines that have been authorized by Western countries and Japan, paving the way for possible imports of Pfizer, Johnson & Johnson and Moderna shots. The move, which will drop the need for companies to do small local safety trials for their vaccines before seeking emergency approval, follows the biggest surge in cases in the country this month. India has the biggest vaccine manufacturing capacity in the world and had exported tens of millions of doses before its own demand skyrocketed and has led to a shortage in some states. Speaking of which, Panujan, the Maharashtra government has now imposed lockdown-like curbs in the state from 8 p.m. Tomorrow. Section 144 has been imposed in the state and only essential services will be allowed for the next 15 days. The Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray also has said that he will request Prime Minister Narendra Modi to direct Air Force to help the state meet its oxygen requirements. Public transport will continue to function only for essential workers and in emergency, and for essential activities for general public. Also, this what's allowed and what's not. Well, there's a whole list of things. The Janta curfew is from 8 p.m. April 14th till 7 a.m. May 1st. No one is allowed to step out unless it's an emergency. Private vehicles can only ply for essential or emergency purposes. Trains and flights will be allowed. No schools and colleges across the state. Private coaching will also need to remain shut. Students traveling for exams may be allowed, but along with one adult on the basis of a valid hall ticket. Restaurants, hotels, everything will remain closed in the meanwhile, and home delivery is allowed at this particular point in time. There's a whole host of items that are there, Bandhijan. If you want to catch up on that, you can go to mediamahima.com. That's all we have time for on this morning's Good Morning Babe and the Gem. We'll be back tonight live at 5 on the Pam Pam Show. Don't forget to tune in for another terrific edition of Mahima's Pam Pam. Have yourselves a terrific Tuesday. I hope you're enjoying every one of these songs that we have lined up for you, Bandhijani. This is Radio D Hotties, where entertainment, engagement, excitement, everything keeps getting hotter.
Hi, this is A.R. Rahman, and you're listening to me on Radio D Hotties with Aldo Baba and Faltu Rani, where entertainment keeps getting hotter.
शंति मार रहा संसार अब तू आने दे ललकार तेरी तो बाहें पतवार कदम है तेरे हाथ